Next thing we're going to do is make some Cajun crackers with the dipping sauce. But first, we have to get the crackers seasoned and ready to soak up all the good juices. First, we're going to add one packet of Hidden Valley Ranch mix.
You can get that stuff at Ross Market, and if you're ever sick, they have pharmacy in stock.
There you go.
So just add that right into the bowl. Sean, can you throw this away for me?
Sure thing.
Thank you. And then we have about a tablespoon of the smoking fire and rub by Creative Cajun Cooking. Add that in there. And we want to mix those together really good. You want to add all your dry ingredients first. And the smoking fire and rub is going to give it a little extra heat without all the salt. It also has that buttery, smoky flavor, which is really good on just about anything. All right, now we got some Gator pickle juice. It's just a juice to make everything stick to the crackers. Just pour that in there. It's about a half a cup. And you want to mix that up really good. And this recipe is similar to the firecracker saltine crackers. And you can find that on the Pinterest. And while you're on Pinterest, you can also go look at the Creative Cajun Cooking page, and we'll also have this recipe on there for you, too.
Now we have some Creative Cajun Cooking classes for Couillons made by Mr. Jimmy, and my mom directed it. So if you have any Couillons out there that loves cooking, you better start to watching because you're going to learn some good food. The video is on the website at creativecajuncooking.com. And you can look up all the recipes from creativecajuncooking.com and look at all the latest episodes from theoutdoorkitchenshow.com.
Now there's two ways you can either do this. You can take the crackers, dip them in there, and put them back. Or you can take a little spoon and pour them over the crackers. I like my flavor on both sides, so I'm going to dip them in there and put them back. It also won't take that long in the microwave when you go to dry them out. These right here are just original Triscuits,
which you can buy at Ralph's Market. How hard is it to make this kind of recipe?
This recipe is not hard at all. It just takes a little bit of time. And that's all. This was the first one I done. You can see how it's kind of getting a little mushy and it's a little discolored versus the one that I haven't done yet. And that's a good thing. You want them to sit here and soak up all the good juices because that's what's going to give it the good flavor. See this one, I put a little bit more on it. So it's going to take a little bit more time for it to soak it up, but that's okay. If some are a little dry, you can dip them back in. It doesn't matter. No way you can mess it up.
Talking, you will do the mixing.
So she's going to be doing the talking, I'm going to be doing the walking.
Oh no, oh no, you do the mixing.
She's going to be doing the gum bumping, you're going to be doing the butt moving.
Yeah, Dad.
Now we're working on the dipping sauce for the Cajun crackers, and Sean here is going to help us. We have a cup of mayonnaise, a cup and a fourth of sour cream, and a tablespoon of the fire department blend swamp dust.
Made by Mr. Jimmy Babin, and he makes all of his products working good food.
All right, Sean. You ready?
Yep.
Go ahead and get you started with the mayonnaise.
A lot of mayonnaise.
Yeah, you need that one to start with. Whenever I had made this at my house, everybody in my house was tearing it up, and we ran out of crackers while eating it, so we started pulling vegetables and all kind of stuff out of the refrigerator in order to eat it, because it was that good. Now we're going to throw in the fire department blend swamp dust.
Which is hot, hot. Ain't like your grandma's hot sauce, that's for sure.
Now I'm going to take my crackers because they done soaked up all the good juices, and I'm going to transfer them onto a paper towel, and I got a cutting board underneath them so I can put them in the microwave easier. So I'm just going to take them and put them on. All right, so now we'll get the first batch going in the microwave. We put them in the microwave for about 2 minutes, and that seemed to work for them. And now I'm going to put them into the oven at 350. And these, put in the oven, you just have to watch them. There's no set time, you just have to watch them.
How do you know when they're done?
When they're brown and crispy. Not burnt, brown and crispy. Now the chips look like they're pretty good, so Go ahead and take them out. You can find my recipe for Cajun crackers and the dipping sauce at creativecajuncooking.com.
And you can also find the recipe at theoutdoorkitchenshow.com.
Would you like to try one?
Sure, why not? Crunchy, creamy, and spicy.
Y'all stay tuned to the Outdoor Kitchen Show.